Yes, mate. All right, there we have it. First ever tattoo completed. Pretty sick, mate. Didn't even hurt that much. It was like half an hour long and I'm absolutely gassed with it. I'm buzzing to like get the cling film off in half an hour. Obviously, I've got to do some aftercare and everything, but honestly, it looks so sick. Mate, I'm buzzing. Let's go, mate. Also, last minute, spontaneous. I don't even know what I'm filming for or like when these clips are gonna go in, mate. Jeez, but Chase and State is playing in Plymouth tonight and I think I'm just gonna fucking go. This is not going to go, but fucking funny me.
Current time is 10:15. I was planning on walking to Prism from here on my ones, listening to the absolute tunes from my AirPods. Turns out Prism is an hour walk away. I do not have tickets. I need to be at Prism for 11 to get tickets, to get them on the door. Mo's gonna drive me. It takes about 10 minutes. Hopefully get there for like 10:30. It should be sound. However, I was planning on drinking two of these pre-mixed cans on the way. But now that it's only a 10 minute drive, I should probably send one now. Advice before you ever down a drink, just do a bit of self-talk. I always think to myself, don't be a pussy. Don't be a pussy. Literally just fucking send it. That's what I think to myself. Don't be no pussy. I'm actually fucking spangled.
Oh yes, yes, about to hit chasing status. In Plymouth, last minute session. Mr. Samuels is not coming because he basically took a load of shrooms and decided that he only likes bassline. So honestly,
I'm off for a fucking nut right now, mate.
Chaser Status is playing.
Am I that guy walking across the road?
Yeah. No, oh, that guy makes you look sober, mate. Sorry, down. Oh, look at him. You can't even see him. He's fucking in another world. But yeah, now legit. Chaser Status is playing in Plymouth, and yeah, Mo doesn't like drum and bass anymore. Only likes bassline after tripping on shrooms, which is really fucking shit for me, mate. Nah, for real though, he's had surgery on his foot, so he can't actually walk.
I lost my face of morphine, mate.
He's also not meant to be driving for like fucking weeks. He's always been driving.
Mate, shut the fuck up.
Shut the fuck up, mate. I've had speedy recovery. Nah, legit though, he's not meant to be driving for weeks, and it's like 3 days per surgery.
The horse tranquilizer.
Yeah.
No, it's not a horse tranquilizer. Horse medicine.
Horse medicine, yeah. Basically,
basically, don't mention it because it's actually a banned substance, but it's got like no data supporting any muscle.
No,
so
it's
I'm
fine.
Still fucking natural as fuck.
Natural as fuck. Basically, you're gonna hit chase status on my own. I'm pretty drunk and I'm gonna get way more drunk and I'm gonna
finger some 17-year-olds.
Yes, yes, all right. So reporting live and exclusive, like 20 past one, I'm pretty spangled. Do you know what, that was fucking sick. Fair play, had a few absolute legends coming up to me and being like, yes, mate, and bought me some rum and cokes. Bear in mind, I got there at like 11. Jesus, fucking car. Got there at like 11. Chase and Stace weren't on until like 1. So I had a few absolute beverages. Do you know what, right? It's weird. Like, Chase and Stace, I've been rinsing their tunes recently. Hard. Like, their OG tunes, A Step Away. I don't know why, but I've just been playing it so much. End credits. But they were playing like halftime. I swear it wasn't even drum and bass. Anyways, regardless, it was a sick night. But Prism in Plymouth, fair play. But you have a lot of 17, 18, whatever year olds there. Had a sick time, but not really about the children life. So what's the time now? Like, coming up to 1:30. And I'm going to find myself a kebabby, mate. Yeah, man. Madness. Had a sick time, though. Highly recommend going out on your own. Yeah, fucking have a few drinks and chat to a few people. Yes. Fucking hell, I'm gonna try and explain to you the next 48 hours, or the last 48 hours, how I've ended up in Romford in London. Basically, to cut a long story short, I bought a new car and it was meant to get delivered yesterday to Plymouth. There was some miscommunication and it accidentally delivered the car to my Winchester address, my parents' place, yesterday. They called me up, my dad called me up and was like, mate, the car's here. And I was like, fuck. Obviously, I was in Plymouth. Couldn't get to Winchester yesterday, so they had to take it back, and the car is from Essex. I had to take it back. I've been on the phone with them all day today. Basically, the bottom line is the dealership in Essex were like, we're not gonna cover the costs of delivering the car again to Plymouth, because it's like free nationwide delivery, but it's almost like I'd used that service, even though I feel like it was their mistake because they didn't deliver it to the right place. Anyway, to cut a long story short, my CIB is pretty much dead now and I need a new car for next week. I couldn't be bothered to go through a process of trying to find another one. I like this car a lot, the one that I'm going to get. Ended up just saying to the geezer, look, mate, whatever. I went out last night as well, was sent it, hungover today. I was like, all right, mate, it's fine. I'll get to you in Essex. So I got on a train in Plymouth today at like 6 p.m. It's now 11 p.m. Basically, what I had to do was, the plan was to get to this place here on the screen. And I hadn't had a place. I don't have a hotel booked or anything. And then I realised on the train that every single hotel in this place was booked. So I was a bit fucked. And then I had to just figure it out. Obviously, I'm like, I don't really get stressed out in these sort of situations, but it is what it is. Like, I'll always figure something out. But basically, the end solution was that I had to find an Airbnb in like a close location. So I've ended up in this place called Romford, and there's an Airbnb here. So that's not too bad. It's not like, it's not too far away from the place that I need to get to tomorrow to pick up the car in Essex. However, Sunday tomorrow, which means trains are just shit. And I've just had a look, and there's no trains running tomorrow. It's replacement buses. So what would be a 20, 25 minute train journey tomorrow morning is gonna be an hour and a half double bus journey, but it is what it is. It's been quite fun. So now I'm in Romford at an 11 p.m. Didn't even plan on being here. And there's two trains coming, so I'm gonna stop talking.
When you were younger, there would be brighter days. What if you could show yourself out in the shadow? There is a bright light, please. Believe me, you got this. You gotta move out of the darkness. Holding back since we were young. You are not the only one. Keep on.
Alright, update. So I'm currently in an Uber. He's just gone out to Starbucks to get us drinks. What an absolute legend. He was like, do you want a drink? And I was like, yeah, sure, go on then, mate. So he's going to get me a black coffee because I've sunk 20 milligrams of Yohimbine this morning and already had one black coffee. So I'm on a bit of a level. I was going to go for a walk, but I didn't have time earlier. And yeah, he's going to get me another black coffee. And he said, do you want any sugar? And I was like, one sweetener. He was like, I'm not actually going to do his accent because I don't know if that's like rude or not. But yeah, I don't think he knows what a sweetener is. But anyways, interesting. Obviously made it to the Airbnb, was pretty sick. The beds were questionable, but I had the choice of three single beds. So that was pretty naughty. Obviously being in London, I'm not used to it. Very noisy. I mean, I'm in Romford. I don't really know much about Romford, but rowdy people in Romford, that's for sure. Lots of screaming and shouting throughout the middle of the night. But anyways, managed to get like an all right sleep in. And yeah, I've been trying to get Ubers all morning. I'd ordered Uber last night, but I'd made it. I'd requested it to go to a place that cars can't get to, and I also hadn't updated my contact details on my Uber. It was my old phone, so they couldn't get through to me. So I had to pay £6 for that, and it got cancelled, and then I had to try and book a new one, so it's been taking a bit of a while. But I've got this geezer now, and he's getting me a Starbucks, one absolute legend. And I'm going to go to the car, which is pretty exciting. Hopefully, we'll go smoothly with that, and then I can get to Tom, because today is Tom's show, UK DFBA, in Camberley, and yeah, I'm pretty gassed, mate, but... Geez, the last like 72 hours has been pretty all over the place. All right, so car's been insured. It's been road taxed. This is a monumental moment because I'm about to crack open my first ever tinny. Oh yeah. Geez. Speaking of which, I'll show you some pictures now. On the screen, I'll just start clicking through them. Basically, it's an Audi A4 2013 TDI SE. Very, very naughty 2-litre diesel. Massive upgrade from the 2005 Seat Ibiza. And this is going to be my first official drive in it, like a longer distance drive. I'm going to go Tesco quick, and then we're going to drive to Camberley. It's like an hour and a half. Through that, I'm going to be doing a lot of driving over the next few days anyway. So, definitely going to get used to it, mate. It's going to be pretty powerful. I wasn't sure if I had a built in sat nav or not. I don't think it does. It's got a 6 screen, but I don't know if it's got built-in sat-nav. And it doesn't have Bluetooth, but it's got an aux. Obviously, it's got an aux input, and it's just fucking clean, mate. So yeah, I'm gonna have to spend a lot of time getting to know the car properly. And also, it's quite funny because, so as I don't have an aux cable, and I don't have, I don't have Bluetooth, I could listen to the radio, but this geezer's left a CD in the car, and it's got like proper, like the sort of tunes I used to listen to back when I used to play basketball. But it does show me how fat the speakers are, and the bass is just silly.
Damn. Life can flip in a matter of seconds.
Get ready, mate. Duty money that's got it. I woke up in a new Bugatti.
I know what's real, I know what's right.
All right, yes, yes, let's finish editing this video. I have no outro.
Okay.
So
down.
No,
you
go on.
Just fucking keeps jumping, mate, again.
Sick one, legend for watching. Catch you in the next one. Hope you enjoyed it. Yes, mate.